and welcome to the very first Cinema Director tutorial. Today we're just going to be taking a look at the basics of Cinema Director. This isn't actually the first Cinema Director tutorial. These are actually a series of remakes where redoing them. The other ones are about a year old at this point and are a little bit outdated because we update this software constantly. Always adding features. When you are using Cinema Director, if you have any suggestions for features, be sure to check out our forums. We're always active on there, and your suggestions could very well affect this software. But anyway, basics, right. So we're going to load up Cinema Director. If you haven't loaded up an asset before, I'm sure you have. Just click on the asset store over here and click this downloads button to see all of the assets you have purchased on the asset store. We've already downloaded it, so we just gotta hit import, and it will import the package into our scene. Yep, import. Okay, now that it's imported, we see we have the Cinema Suite folder in our hierarchy here. We're going to come over to Window, and Cinema Suite, and Cinema Director, and we're going to go to Director. And as you see, our director window opens up here. And we've put a lot of work into making director really Unity compliant. And what I mean by that is that it's pretty much indistinguishable from other windows in Unity. It just looks like it's part of the program. And just like any other window, we can dock it wherever we want. So we're going to drag it down to the bottom here. That's my favorite place to put it. You want a nice kind of long space, or maybe if you have a second monitor, works great with that too. The more real estate, the better, because trust me, you're gonna wanna put a lot of stuff in your scene and things can get crowded pretty quick. So to create a new cutscene, we come over here to this create dropdown and hit new cutscene. It opens up this little window, which we can expand here. We can name our cutscene, call it Tutorial 1. You can set a duration in advance. All of these things, all of these attributes you can change after, like the number of different track groups and stuff, which I will explain in a little bit. But I'm going to leave all this stuff as is for now, and we're going to hit Create Cutscene. And just like we told it to do, gave us a director group with three tracks, a shot track and two audio tracks. So that's a blank cutscene, but how about we take a look at a already populated cutscene? That might be the best way to do this. If we go over to example scenes and then open our director basic scene. Don't save, that's okay. All right, this is our example scene with our very own director bot up there. As you can see, our tracks right now are all tucked away inside of their respective groups. So if we open up the director group, we have our shots. If we go to game mode, we can scrub through here and actually see, the cuts between those shots, and you can hear when we're scrubbing, we do get audio scrubbing with it, so that's pretty neat. You can see our fade in and out happening there. If we zoom in here, you can see there's some events triggered down there. And yeah, how about we just give it a watch? And yeah, we'll see how it goes.
Greetings, humanoid Unity user. I am Director Bot, the most awesome directing robot ever created. I'm here to demonstrate all of the cool things you can do in Cinema Suite's Cinema Director. If you're watching this, it means you have already figured out how to play a cutscene in Cinema Director. Well done. It's almost like you never needed me at all. Open the director window and keep an eye on the director group to watch for cool things as they happen in the game window. If you look at the shot track, you can see when a shot ends and the camera switches to the next shot. In the audio track, you can cue up your favorite sounds. And with global tracks, you can do all sorts of things, like fade the cutscene to black. Good night. In addition to the director group, we also have actor groups. From here you can assign an actor and control its properties and actions over time. For example, We can have me dance a robot dance. But we can get cooler. We can also make new game objects appear. Yes, it's that easy. We can now have a cube suspended in the air that didn't exist before. Wow. But we can get cooler still. You can spawn any game object, including intelligent beings. Hi, Fred.
Oh, hi, Director Bot. I'm really excited to help you out with the demonstration.
But we can get even cooler. We can do all sorts of things with our beautiful new cube, like increase its mass to... Oh, let's choose at random. 1,000 kilograms, and watch it interact with the world. Haha, that never gets old. Those are the basics of Cinema Director. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. Now go make a cool cutscene.
Alright, so there you go. There's the sample cutscene that comes with Director, where Director Bot kind of explains things a little bit. Maybe even better than me. But right, like he said, inside of Director Groups, which you create groups up here, there's things like shot tracks, dialogue tracks, kind of things that more globally affect the scene instead of targeting a specific object, because that's what these actor groups are for. So you make a, like we call this one Director Bot group, and then we target Director Bot in particular. You get a little picker with that. And from there we can choose to add an actor track and choose what you know, attribute we want to edit for that specific game object that we're targeting. There's also character tracks, which I will explain in another tutorial, but they're specifically good for humanoid characters. You get real-time mechanism scrubbing and stuff like that. But anyway, just to wrap this up, let's take another look at the interface here. We have our start and stop buttons. You can also use the space bar for that, for, well, playing and pausing anyway. Stop brings you back to the beginning. We have this button here, which actually rebakes your character track group for when you're doing real-time mechanism animations. If you change something, you have to click that so the preview will update and then you can live scrub again. This button here targets the root, the cutscene, which is comes in handy so you don't have to go and dig for it. We have the little snapping magnet over here, so when you're, let's just zoom in a bit. If you're moving something around, if you have snapping on, it'll see snap to these lines. Whatever lines are currently up there, but if you have snapping off, then you can just move it around to whatever position you'd like. This button here actually resizes the window to fit the entire cutscene, which is also handy. We also have zoom in and out. This next button toggles preview mode. Preview mode is enabled automatically when you're scrubbing, and you need to be out of preview mode to actually start changing things, like selecting game objects, changing curves, and stuff like that. So if you're ever wondering why you can't change something, just come over here and click that button. This next button is our settings panel, which doesn't have much just yet, except for the option to enable beta features, which you should probably leave off unless you want a specific feature that's in beta. And then we have a help button with some handy links. But anyway, guys, that about does it for this Cinema Director tutorial. Just getting the scene kind of set up, getting in here. In the next one, we're going to cover director groups, what they are, how to use them, so be sure to check out our next tutorial for that. Alright guys, I'm Mitch from Cinema Suite, thanks for watching.